What's up guys, it's Toby here and welcome! Let me know which players do you want me to sign in the summer transfer window. Oh wow, this just looks so awesome. And our route to the Champions League route, which was Real Madrid being demolished 5-0. It wasn't a 5-0 game, probably the fair scoreline would have been 3-1 or 4-2, something like that. So maybe a 2 or 3 goal win. 5 goals was a little bit harsh on Real Madrid, but we were just ruthless in front of goal. And as I said, in the quarterfinals, there were only big teams left. And I think we earned it because we knocked out Juventus on the way to the final, but also Juventus beat us in the group stage, if you remember. But then we beat them in the second game in the group stage, and then we beat them at home again in the semi-finals. And also Real Madrid got through a pretty tough group, and then Real Madrid knocked out Tottenham, and then they knocked out Barcelona, and then they knocked out Bayern Munich. So Real Madrid also had a very hard route to the final, where, oh my goodness, I think Real Madrid would wish they didn't get to the final, because losing a Champions League final 5-0 is devastating. Man United won a lot of trophies, even though they weren't even in the Champions League, which is quite weird that Manchester United got all the way to the Europa League final. And considering that they have a much bigger and better team than in real life, they will get a very good run at the Champions League trophy next season. They beat Leverkusen in the final, but Manchester United not only won the Europa League, but Man United also finished second in the Premier League, and also Man United won the FA Cup and the League Cup. So Man United actually won a treble, a mini treble if you like, Europa League, FA Cup and League Cup. I think Man United had a very good season, but of course we had a better season than Man United, because the Champions League trophy is always the biggest one. And I already showed you the Premier League trophy, but now I showed you how all the other competitions finished. You know, we won the Community Shield as well, that's not a big trophy, but next season we will have a chance to win the European Super Cup. That's a much bigger trophy than the Community Shield. I really hope we manage to win that. Oh wow, Man United demolished Leeds 7-0 on aggregate in the Carabao Cup semi-finals. That's really tough for Leeds. They are unlucky. And we got knocked out by Chelsea in the League Cup on penalties. That was painful as well. So Salah didn't win the top scorer award in the Champions League. He actually finished third behind Sané and Immobile, but Ronaldo was also a player with 8 goals, Marcus Rashford as well. There are just so many absolutely top quality strikers in the Champions League. Jadon Sancho in the end finished on 5 goals, considering that in the first half of the season he only played as a substitute. That's pretty amazing. And what also amazes me is that Victor Osimhen got 6 assists in the Champions League. He got the most assists in the competition alongside De Bruyne. And Osimhen is an even bigger, like even more a substitute player than Sancho was this season. And clean sheet wise, Alisson kept 4 clean sheets in the Champions League. It's amazing that he actually kept only 2 more clean sheets in the Premier League, in the whole Premier League campaign, than he did in the Champions League. That's pretty remarkable. Also in the Europa League, of course, De Gea kept the most clean sheets. Pogba and Martial and Willian Jose finished all on 9 goals. And wow, Pogba and Martial had a great run in the Europa League. Fred and Martial also had 5 assists, De Gea 9 clean sheets, so no wonder Man United won the Europa League. I already showed you the Premier League statistics. Salah won the top scorer award, Firmino the top assist award, Ederson got the most clean sheets. In the FA Cup, also just like in the Champions League, Leroy Sané was the top scorer. Man City got the most, got the player with the most goals. Hugo Lloris kept the most clean sheets. In the League Cup though, all Man United, Müller, Pogba got the top scorer awards in the League Cup. Müller got the most assists, De Gea got the most clean sheets, and Man United won both domestic cup competitions. And that's a little bit painful to me. So next season I will make sure that Man United don't win 3 trophies. This is how our top scorers chart finished. So Mohamed Salah has 37 goals, which is absolutely amazing. 27 in the Premier League, 8 in the Champions League, and 1 each in the FA Cup and the Community Shield. Mane, even though he was out injured for 2 months at the end of the season, he still finished as our second top scorer alongside Jadon Sancho, but Sancho only finished in second, joined second with Mane because Mane got injured. But considering that Mane is 29 and Sancho is 21, and Mane already his rating started declining because of that injury, Jadon Sancho is the future of Liverpool. Mane is the current, is the present. Firmino with 16 goals, pretty good return. Kai Havertz with 15 goals. Oh wow, he really stepped up in the last 2 months of the season, I have to be honest. And Naby Keita opened the scoring in the Champions League final, so he will be forever in Liverpool folklore. He got 12 goals and 15 assists as well. And look at how many assists our players have. Usually it's the midfielders, but Firmino actually finished with the most assists. And Oxlade-Chamberlain as a backup player, 9 goals, 9 assists, very good numbers. And considering that our team is still at a pretty good age, Salah, Mane and Firmino will decline in 1 or 2 seasons, but I will keep them as long as possible because they are Liverpool legends. Osimhen, only 22 years old, 7 goals, 11 assists, very good. Szoboszlai, only 20. 7 goals, 5 assists. Divock Origi, 6 goals, 4 assists. It will be difficult next season to keep the rotation going because we will have Brewster back. So maybe I will sell Origi or Osimhen. I'm not 100% sure what I will do. We will probably have too many strikers. Or maybe I will loan out Osimhen for just one season. Next season I will see what I will do. But Wilson also is at a good age. Grujic got better at Arsenal, he scored 4 goals, which is pretty decent. Minamino scored 3 goals, that was in one game in the Premier League. Pretty incredible stuff. And it will be difficult to keep Minamino playing, but I will try my best. And Jordan Henderson rounds up the guy who also got a goal this season. And Kamil Grabara got better, he got a plus 1 rating at I think it's Standard Liège, but he's still a long way away from being our backup goalkeeper. And considering we have so many goalkeepers, and I had Callum Heumann-Kelleher all season on the transfer list, I will just release him because at the moment we just can't sell him and we don't want to be stuck with him for a long time. And considering that John Gray, who is going on loan next season, is already better than Kelleher, I think it's justified that we let Kelleher go. The other player that I want to release is Phillips, who I tried to sell all season and I just couldn't. So let's release him, and that's our two players released. And I think I'm selling Lovren. Yeah, he's moving on at the end of the season. Henry Lewis already got a plus 4 upgrade. That's a very, very good upgrade for Henry Lewis. So that's really, really awesome. Van den Berg also got a plus 1 upgrade. I'm really happy with that. Chilwell got a plus 2 rating increase. And as you can see, a lot of his ratings got a lot better. Larucci is another player that I just can't loan out. He was on the loan list all season and he just didn't want to go on loan. I accepted all loan deals, as you can see, and he rejected all of them. Very, very unlucky. And I don't think I can play Larucci in a lot of games next season, considering that he's only 67. He has very good speed, as you can see, but his defensive awareness is only still just 64, even though he grew 4 rating points. Angus Gunn also got a lot better. I just wanted to show you that. And let's see who improved massively. Gomez also, from an 84 to an 86 rated player, got a lot better this season. Alexander-Arnold, already 85 rated at the start of the season, he also got better. Aarons improved by 3 rating points and we only signed him in January. This guy will be a very, very good player. Kiana Hoover, I think still he needs to play on loan just like Connolly, but look at this guy, Neil Connolly, already growing very, very nicely. And also Grujic got a 1 rating boost. And I think long term, he will be the long term replacement for Jordan Henderson. I still want to keep Grujic on loan because I think Henderson and Fabinho is enough to very good defensive midfielders. I won't sell Henderson anytime soon. He's still our backup captain. Joel Davis already improved by 3 and he's going out on loan next season. Morris also just got promoted from the youth academy. He improved very nicely. Naby Keita and Wijnaldum improved, and I will say Wijnaldum got worse. Sorry, I will say Wijnaldum was a very good servant for us. He scored 5 goals this season and 4 assists, and that's the parting gift for Wijnaldum, a Champions League medal, another one around his neck. So Wijnaldum leaves as a 2-time Champions League winner, and I think at 30 years old he will play a lot of games at, I think, Dortmund. He's going at Dortmund. Curtis Jones also improved by 2 rating points, but he needs to get better because he's only 67 A rated. Ajario also needs to get a little bit better, but 77 rated is already very, very good rating. And it's weird for me that Ajario has a 10 rating point difference to Curtis Jones, because I don't think they are that much different. I think Ajario should be about 2 or 3 rating points better than Curtis Jones, but Minamino also improved very nicely, as you can see, just like Kai Havertz. And Woodburn also got a +2 rating point increase, and Szoboszlai, wow, what a player already. 4 rating point increase. Yes, we trained him very hard this season, but I wanted him to get better so I can get him more playing time, and it worked. Sancho also got a massive +4 rating boost, and his finishing improved by 10, which is absolutely crazy. I'm not sure why Mane's physical attributes went down, maybe because of his injury. Ojo also improved by 2 rating points, and again, he's another player who I just can't loan out. I accepted a loan move to Fenerbahce and Ojo rejected it. Not sure why, because he hardly ever plays. Shaqiri also will transfer away from our club back to Inter, and he was also a pretty good servant. He couldn't score, just 8 games played, but last season Shaqiri had a much bigger role and he scored quite a few goals. Harry Wilson, it's weird to see him in an Everton shirt, but Everton got an offer for him and I accepted it. Everton are not our rivals in terms of the Premier League positions. I know they are rivals in real life and on career mode, but they weren't threatening our position, so I just said, why not? This is a game, not in real life. So Harry Wilson went to Everton just for a season. He will be back next season. Paul Glatzel, a German striker who is improving constantly and getting better all the time. And Ryan Brewster, oh wow, what a player. Just look at that, already 81 rated. I can't wait to use him next season. 87 finishing, that will be awesome to use next season. I mean, yeah, I might sell Origi and just put Brewster in, because Origi is 26, Brewster is 21, or I'm not sure, or I will loan out Osimhen, one of the two. Maybe Osimhen on loan is a little bit harsh, but he's the same rating as Brewster, and I don't have that emotional connection with Osimhen. Brewster is a Liverpool-like youngster in real life, and I would love to see him succeed. So yeah, maybe that's what I will do. Maybe loan out Osimhen for 1 or 2 seasons. So our manager rating is 74, and that's not very good. The main reason for that is that we failed to win the Premier League and we failed to win the FA Cup, and we weren't even close to winning those. But we won the Champions League, which was one of the crucial objectives. Also, we earned enough pounds from shirt sales. We didn't develop the youth academy, but that was, I mean, we didn't develop the youth academy the way the club wanted, but that was a low priority. And the financial objective, which is a long-term objective, is almost completed. So overall, I think we did pretty well, and I hope that we will stay on as a Liverpool manager, because I will be devastated if they sack me, to be honest, right now. And also, in the beginning of next season, we will need to extend the contracts of Van den Berg and Kiana Hoover. The other players still have more than 2 years on their contracts, so no problems there. Maybe I will extend the contract of Brewster, because he will get better and better very, very soon. And I also wanted to tell you guys that Brighton and Norwich, two former Premier League teams, got promoted, but the third team will be maybe a new team, maybe Leeds, maybe Bristol, maybe Nottingham, but it could be Sheffield United, who in real life are in the Premier League. So it's a very interesting championship table, very realistic as well, I have to say. I'm a little bit surprised that Sheffield only finished in fourth place, because in real life they have an awesome team, but on FIFA maybe not so much. And I just wanted to show you the other leagues as well. PSG in one hell of a title race, won the French league, just 2 points ahead of Monaco. Absolutely crazy that both teams finished on like more than 100 points. And also let's check out the Bundesliga. Bayern Munich in also an incredible title race, won the Bundesliga by just 1 point, and they were unbeaten as well, which is just out of this world. And let's check out the other big leagues, the Serie A, Juventus and Lazio. Oh my goodness, no wonder Lazio were such a tough team in the Champions League round of 16. They finished on a 101 points, and Inter, 99 points for Inter, and they only finished in third place. Like, what, absolutely crazy. And this is why it's very, very difficult to win the Premier League, for example, because like in the Premier League, you also have a lot of teams finishing with more than 100 points sometimes, or close to 100 points, but at least more than 90 points. A lot of teams finish in the Premier League on 90 plus points. Ajax won the Dutch league ahead of PSV, so that's not really a surprise. Ajax are an awesome side. Benfica won the Portuguese league, that's also not a surprise really. They usually won the Portuguese league. Celtic won the Scottish league ahead of Steven Gerrard's Rangers, which is a shame because I want Gerrard to win trophies at Rangers. Real Madrid won the Spanish league ahead of Barcelona. So Real Madrid not only beat Barcelona to the title, but they also beat them in the Champions League quarterfinals, and Real Madrid only drew 2 games. Oh my goodness, this is amazing that we beat this Real Madrid team 5-0, who absolutely destroyed the whole of La Liga. That's now an even bigger and more impressive feat. And my favorite team, Real Betis, in the Spanish league, finished in 6th place, so they will qualify for the Europa League next season. That's pretty awesome. The Turkish league was won by Fenerbahce ahead of Beşiktaş and Galatasaray. And also the MLS is not completed, but New York City are in first place at the moment. And we are in a very healthy financial position. As you can see, we have about 100 million transfer budget. So let me know which team or which players should we sign in the summer transfer window. And also, I think that we collected a lot of shirt sales this season. I mean, we earned 359 million in merchandise, and we sold a total of 7,300,000 shirts, with the highest selling shirts Salah, Kai Havertz and Jadon Sancho. That's pretty awesome. And also you can check that the total prize money that we earned is £253 million. So overall we were in profit by £424 million. So if the board sacked me after I made a profit of 424 million. They are absolutely crazy. I mean, look at how much we earned in total throughout the season. And I will try to show you these statistics more often at the end of each season, because I think it's pretty interesting to look at. And I also wanted to show you my overall career numbers. And of course, let's check out this season. So this season we won the Champions League, the Community Shield, but I think we should have done better in the Premier League, only finishing in third. We didn't finish in the top two in the Premier League in either of the seasons that we completed in the Liverpool career mode. So I will try to do better next season. And of course, Jadon Sancho was the record transfer. Will we break that next season? Do you want me to sign somebody crazy like Mbappe? I don't think it's time for that. I want to sign players like that when we sell or when Salah, Mane or Firmino retire. That's the only way where I really want to sign a forward player with as crazy as that. And yeah, last season we won the FA Cup, the Community Shield, the UEFA Super Cup. So I think this season was better, even though we won less trophies, we won one of the big trophies. and that is the Champions League. Any season where Liverpool wins the Champions League is an incredibly successful season. I really hope that you guys enjoyed this episode. Thanks for watching. Hope you are well and have a nice day. See you later, guys. Goodbye.